Well, here we go. Thanks to a buddy of mine, Robert, got me some 243 brass. Not a big 243 guy, but I do have a 788 Remington that I had bought for resale. But anyway, just kind of digging the old school vibe. So anyway, he had some extra 243, which you know how that is. Extra brass for a caliber you have is kind of an oxymoron. But anyway, he was going to be making a run out, I don't remember now, West Texas or somewhere, and he was going to be bringing a lot more back. So he gave me some, a little bit of Remington. I think there was some Hornady in there, which, as you guys know, I'm not a big fan of Hornady brass. I really love their bullets, just not a big fan of their brass. And then he had a bunch of these, and these are Federals. Let's see if I can get that in there to focus. Yeah, not going to happen. Anyway, Robert gave me these. I think there's about 45, 50 of these. And being the consummate reloader that he is, these babies are all sized. The mouths have been chamfered and deburred inside and out and pretty much ready to load. He and I are on the same vein in the fact that we do all the hard work on the brass and then put it in a bag, so when you're ready to load, you just get after it. There's Butch the reloading dog. Hey, Butch. What you doing, buddy? Anyway, we're going to prime these bad boys and get them ready to load. Okay, and now we're going to go to priming them using our RCBS Universal Primer. Again, we want them countersunk a little. Yowza. Didn't get that name good. I'm not going to show you all of them, just the final five. Yeah, we're primed, ready to go. Yeah, I've got a little cheesy plastic glove on. I'm very acidic. And, you know, you spend all that time prepping your brass, making it look good, and then you get fingerprints on it, and then they funk up, and that's just not good. So, anyway, here we go. And I think I've showed you this before. Always, always, always. Especially when the powder's like this, not the Trail Boss, which is a little donuts or something like that. Always put the powder that's in it on top of it. As you can see, there's a pound of powder there. There's 3 or 4 pounds of powder over here. And yeah, you can make yourself a very bad day if you don't keep track of what's in that Charge Master. Okay, the Charge Master has beeped at me. He told me that we have the correct setting on there, which I have verified 2 different locations with this load. This being a little bullet, we're trying to get it to travel fast, so I go against my own thing and I'm going to max load. And my rainy day stuff, I ran across these are Midway bulk 243s, and it says right here on top, normally it don't, that these are Remington projectiles. So these are factory Remington core locks. We know how good they work. Set your dies up the way your die specifies, but I usually set my overall length first before I do the crimp. We're going to do the little measuring right quick. That's really close to where we're wanting to go. Okay. I'm sitting here looking, we readjusted the dies. We seated our overall length and then adjusted that back up. Let it go down till it touched the mouth of the case. Put a little bit down, more downforce on it, which would make the print. And then readjusted the stem for the seating guide. And now we've got perfect rounds. I'm sitting here thinking we're equal opportunity employers here. We're using a Federal case, Remington bullets, and Winchester primers. We just about got the gambit covered. And that, my friends, is how it's done. We're going to load up 20 of these. We're shooting 100 grain. Just the number I like on a 243. Doesn't mean it's right, wrong, or indifferent, but just what I had in mind. And with our load being a short barrel, this thing's probably only going to be about 2,800 feet a second. It's 788. Doesn't have a real long barrel on it. And what a nice thing to do on Memorial Day. Think about the men and women that we lost to defend our freedom to do this. Beautiful. To remember Memorial Day is to remember or memorialize the ones we lost. Okay. It's always a good day to think of that. That's not what today is about. And that's just, isn't that just sexy? That's just beautiful. This right here is going to knock down either a really nice deer, but I'm betting money it's going to be real good hog medicine. That's the plan. Shooting paper is all good and fine, but I really like to put organic meat in the freezer. No steroids, no weirdness. Natural, the way God made them. Waiting on the beat. There it is. Alright, so I'm not going to bore you with the continuation of doing this over and over and over. So we'll get to the end, and I'll jump back on here for you. And that, boys and girls, is what we're going after. That is 20 of the most perfect 243 rounds that I could load. Can't wait to go to the range, just see where we can make them poke holes in paper and then be ready to go shoot next time we get a chance. So, we'll wind her up. That being said, looks like it's raining again. Thank a veteran. Thank all the first responders that take care of us on a daily basis. And God bless America. More importantly, God bless Texas.